Wait. Hold up. Wait. Just give me a second. I'm walking over. You're okay. Sorry.
So nice of you to join us, Justin.
Took you long enough.
Was graduating. Hi guys, how's it going? My name is Justin.
I'm Gabe.
Steven.
I'm David, wearing a polymorphic suit that makes me 100 times sexier and stuff.
This is episode 101 of DangIT Prodcast. In this episode, I graduated.
Woo!
Thank you. From college, now I have more time until I lose time later on. Anyway, I have from work, if I get a full-time job.
You mean the non-existent job?
The non-existent job.
Oh, yeah, you graduated. No more job for you.
Oh.
Not making reaction videos is a full-time job.
There's so many hours taken up by sleeping, you know? That's also not reacting. Anyway.
Seen any good movie trailers lately?
No.
No? Me neither.
No.
Sorry, fans.
Ironically, the last movie I ever saw was The Graduate.
Oh, what to say?
I'm just kidding. I actually did watch that for one of my classes last year.
God, what movie was The Graduate?
I totally forget.
Wow, man. Must have been a great fucking movie.
But I do have a few things on my phone just to talk about in this podcast. Aside from I guess graduation, we actually just covered that. So we're good.
Phone to their graduation. Are you trying to take a selfie up on stage?
No.
He only has three of them.
Although someone did do that a few times. Yep. Selfie stick and everything. Anyway.
Did you smack it out of the hands and burn it with fire?
No, I was sitting watching them.
Okay. Where's the anger coming from, my friend?
Everywhere.
Did someone shit in your cornflakes, Steven? Because that's the only reason I could ever see anyone being that much of an asshole right now.
No, I'd murder if somebody turned my Frosted Flakes into Cocoa Pebbles.
Cocoa Flakes.
No, thank you.
Did you guys see the Star Fox Zero animation?
Yes, I did.
And it was?
No.
So it was a Star Fox animation that I saw then.
Yep, on Nintendo's channel.
I didn't see it on... I saw it on, what's it called? 4chan and whatnot. But I was like, God, they look like... They look like that belongs in Star Fox or something. Did they make a Star Fox anime? And then you're like, oh, there was a thing. I'm like, oh.
Huh. That clip and Star Fox Zero in general looks fantastic.
So clean.
Oh my goodness. I watched Pro Jared's video. Not Pro Jared. The Completionist.
Oh.
By the way, Gerard, love you. Have my children. But it looks so solid. I actually genuinely want to play it.
Yeah, me too. After all, these product placements of the game, and then seeing the animation, I really want.
This episode brought to you by Coca-Cola and Miyamoto.
Minus the Coca-Cola and all the Miyamoto.
No, we want free soda.
We do, but there's no way we get sponsored by a soda brand.
You never know. You can ask nicely.
I was actually thinking of how that would actually happen. As I just jinxed myself with it. Just get an email one day hey, it's some obscure soda brand that we've never heard of.
I wouldn't care.
I'd give it a try.
As long as it tasted semi-decent, I wouldn't care.
You mean drinkable?
What?
You mean it is drinkable?
Not even drinkable. As long as it was fairly decent. It doesn't have to be drinkable.
What about that soda that you brought over for one of our challenges?
Oh, dang, that's good cream soda.
No, the one that tasted I think some kind of meat.
Oh,
the bacon one?
No. It was a beef jerky. Beef jerky flavored soda. It was mediocre. I mean,
for me, it was all right. I mean, there's also bubblegum flavored soda.
Which was fantastic.
That bubblegum was good.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's
teaser. Oh, man. Sorry.
I'm sorry you're, a bitch, Steven.
Jesus Christ.
Game I'm here to kick ass and
right now, I'm
drink
trying to get
bubblegum.
Myself to be able to play some Minecraft from over here.
How's the reception?
Perfect.
Okay, good. I was just wondering about the controller.
Oh, the controller? It's fine. However, it's trying to make me player 3. Yeah. I'm not player three. I don't know how to remedy this.
Okay. So, this, like, I think it was, yeah, earlier this week, there was announced that Prince passed away.
He did.
Do you guys know more about Prince than I do?
People keep annoying the shit out of me with the Purple Rain. Ugh.
Like, that's a song? I don't know much about Prince.
You don't?
No. I'm pretty sure I've heard, like, his songs
before. You've heard a few of his songs?
I'm pretty sure, yeah. Just, no, I don't know him as an artist.
I saw this one post that made me just fucking giggle. It said, a kid asked me today who Prince was. I said, he's the man who helped your parents fuck. He's 33% your dad.
That's pretty good. Prince was before my time, so I really don't know too much about him, but I do know that he was a pretty cool guy.
He seemed cool.
He did a lot of things, and
I like
is there meth one of them?
And all that. Huh?
Except it was meth one of them?
I mean, maybe. It was crazy time back then.
I'll be back. This shit's fucking pissing me off saying I'm player three right now.
You have to earn player one, Gabriel. You don't just get it.
Bitch, I earned player one by right.
No.
Oh, Jesus. I just totally like knocked over someone's phone.
Notch said that I own Minecraft now, so you have to do what I say.
I totally forgot what I was going to say. But yeah, I didn't have like much emotions like flowing through me like when Prince passed away, but something that actually did happen was I'm trying to remember like the relations. I think my mom's mom and my dad's aunt passed away as well recently.
Oh no, I'm sorry about it. Did you hear that?
I mean, it's cool. My mom had to fly over to Vietnam just to like do the whole ceremony thing. And so she missed my graduation, which is totally fine. It's not a big deal. What really is irking me is the fact that I'm seeing like an entire generation starting to pass away.
Welcome to getting older.
Yeah, I mean, that's like the nature of things, but I'm seeing stuff happening on Gabe's screen right there. But yeah, it's kind of crazy to see like people pass away. Even like during my graduation, one of the speakers talked about how she was going, that it was like her final moments of life, her final years, and how it was the beginning of ours as the graduates. And it's kind of shocking because you don't really think about that. Like them actually passing on like the torch to the next generation until you're like transitioning into like the adulthood, I would say. Maybe for some people it's younger that they realize that, but for me it was just today. On a brighter note, I was able to send
a brighter night. On a brighter note, everybody just enjoy your life while you have it before you're vaporized into a nuclear cinder sometime in the next 12 years.
Basically become Fallout 5 in real life.
Just be a kid as long as you can, because you're never going to be an adult. Just remember that.
Yeah, you'll spend most of your lives as an adult.
Turn down for what? Nuclear fallout.
But yeah, I was happy about my graduation because I got to sit in the shade for most of the time, so... Ooh, there's a plus.
I'm guessing it was hot at the bowl?
It wasn't, like, super hot, but it was sunny for sure. But yeah, Gabe, what's going on?
I got it. I just had to turn it off and on again.
Ah.
It's the solution to 99% of every technical problem in the world.
Just restart.
Yeah. And if it's not that
hitting it...
Yeah. If hitting it, restarting it, or anything like that doesn't work, all you have to do is just plug it in. Because if none of those fix the problem, the problem is it's not plugged in.
If it is plugged in?
Then you didn't have a problem in the first place.
Divert all power to the main breakers! No, unplug it! And plug it back in for 15 seconds!
Oh,
but... Is it working now?
But Justin, you're asking, like...
Fire the lasers! How the
stream is going?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
That's pretty sharp.
Yeah.
Nice. So, for as long as the cord is, yeah, that works. But, I totally forgot what I was going to say. you can hear it!
Did it have to do with laser beams, by any chance?
No, but I wish it did.
We should talk about laser beams. What's your favorite thing about laser beams?
My favorite thing about laser beams is how they just go in a line. They don't worry about the bullshit and take the scenic route. Nah, they go straight to their target.
Short, sweet, to the point.
Yeah.
Yeah, that too.
You can blind
kind of. No.
Well,
yeah, by shooting them in the eye with a laser beam.
I was gonna make a my dick joke, but I was like, it's not short. You and I doubt it's sweet. Oh, I hear reports online that tends to be bitter.
Ugh. Not if you eat a lot of pineapple.
Who has time for that?
Noted.
You I don't know. And I was eating a bunch of pineapple the other day, and I asked him if he was trying to get his willy waxed.
Yeah. What I do like about laser beams, especially in anime, is when it actually starts shooting out and like becomes like a ball, which like transfers into like a very thin laser. It's just like, well, especially if it's like a gigantic laser. And so it's just like, it's exponentially that large, but then like, I hope you understand what I mean by that. No,
when you say...
Are you kind of like trying to describe a Kamehameha wave?
Kind of. Except a little, I guess a little bit more volume than like what you usually see.
That's not laser though.
Kind of like the father-son Kamehameha wave.
Yeah. My favorite thing about laser beams in anime is when they have a scene where somebody gets shot with laser beams and they just cut to the like wide panning shot of like just him making like a grimacy face when the laser beams are going around him but none of them are actually hitting the guy. It just shows him just flying backwards in slow motion in a static pose with laser beams around him. And then they have the voice actor just go, ah! Limited animation is a treasure.
I do remember that really... Oh, no! I remember that really cool scene in Resident Evil 4 where Leon has to dodge all those lasers in that one hallway.
Oh, yeah.
Jeez, it's been a minute since I played Resident Evil 4. Whew.
Like, yeah.
I never beat it. And I never got past like the first area because I was like, this game is boring and I don't like it.
I totally go
no. Sometimes you have to be honest about a game. Oh, that reminds me. Remember how that one dude wanted us to play Subnautica?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. Well, I got it on my computer, played it for a bit, it's shit.
Is it?
Yeah. Think Minecraft, but to craft things you have to have the blueprints. To get blueprints, the mothership that you like crash landed in has to go through a series of explosions and scatters the blueprints. Ugh. But that happens every now and again.
Wait, I thought you said it was good. Because you were playing it and you said it was alright when you first started playing it.
It was. It looked cool. But then I was like trying to craft a whole bunch of things and whatnot. And I realized I can't craft shit because I don't have the blueprint.
Oh, that's kind of ass.
Yeah.
That kind of reminds me of another game that you were playing on your computer.
Which one?
Shoot, it was just like, you know, like your classic like
Hotline Miami.
Survive like some kind of zombie apocalypse.
Except oh, 7 days to Die?
Something like that, yeah.
They're virtually the same thing in a matter of like you need blueprints to create things, but to create your house, you don't need blueprints in it. Hmm. In Subnautica, to create like good things, like a new ship or something to get around in the water in, you have to have the blueprint for it. Oh, okay. If you want to upgrade your weapon, you have to have a blueprint for it. If you want to get a new weapon, you have to have a blueprint for it.
Now that I think about it, like, if you like, if Minecraft was a little bit more like real life, you would need blueprints. So it's right now, it's just skipping the middleman. But speaking of Minecraft, for those of you who don't know, we've actually like taken like quote unquote a break since 97, just so we can spend the next three episodes actually fighting the Ender Dragon. So we've been like prepping ever since then. That was like maybe a week or two ago.
It's been 2 weeks.
Wow. And you still got, you guys still received some updates. Of course, by the time this is uploaded, you don't. So,
yeah.
Hopefully by the following week after this is posted, then.
I plan to contribute nothing.
All we need is bodies in there to help distract it.
True that. All I gotta do is just start running. I got, like, swift potions.
Never has anyone spent more time doing nothing in Minecraft than I have.
Right?
Steven?
What?
An example?
Remember that one time everyone was doing something?
Yeah, you remember time I didn't do shit?
I don't do shit. Like, all I do is take care of my castle. That's all I do.
Can you explain to me, that mushroom fortress you built on top of your mountain?
Yes. What is that and why is it created?
He was trying to make an enemy, like, just like a spawn for enemies. So he, like, built an entire room, like, but the idea was that they would fall down and instantly die from the height.
But
to get the materials and
how'd you fucked up?
I don't know water.
But then again, water would defeat the purpose, too.
I tried fucking science, everything, and the fucking water's always against me, so I'm like, fuck it, I give up, and I just left it there.
Can't you just, like, bring buckets of water up there?
You can.
That's not the problem. The water is, when it goes down, the mob is just gonna go...
Yeah, so essentially...
There's a way around that. You just have to set it to where the edge of the cliff is at the maximum distance that the water can push.
I know, I have to build higher.
Well, so wait, Gabe, what happens if you... what happens if you were to go up inside that big structure and just drop a bucket of water in there?
The one that Steven made?
Yeah.
The water would fall?
Really?
Yeah, it'd create a waterfall.
Yeah.
Don't go chasing waterfalls.
God, you beat me to it.
please stick to the river, the lakes and the rivers that you're used to.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, they'll go chasing waterfalls in Nether. They are pretty fast. As I've been told.
Yes! Lava acts just like water in the Nether. There's no more, like, when you're playing in the above world. You know, like, when you hit a small spigot of lava and it's just like, I'm coming for you, Jimmy. I'm coming for you. Nah, in the Nether, it's, where you at, bitch?
I still haven't gone and done anything in the Nether. Maybe I'll do that.
It's not a fun place to be.
It's not. Especially at the fortress there. Or, yeah.
Yeah, remember the one thing I did do in the Nether is that I went in there and I dug straight down with a pickaxe and then I fell in lava and died.
Right.
Did you do that in an episode?
Yeah, I did.
I'm going to have to find it. Just to see the initial, oh.
Yeah.
So this is what...
Because I don't imagine you having any good intention out of that other than what's down here. And so I'm imagining you digging, hitting lava and just like, oh, that's what's here.
Oh, so that's why they tell me to not dig down. But yeah, what else is there? I pretty much kind of exhausted my own discussions.
You only had those two topics?
Well, I talked about the passing of the prince and also some of my family members.
The prince.
The prince. No, prince. Passing a prince and passing my other family relatives. Which, yeah, so.
Hey, Steven.
What?
If I pay you real money, can I commission a Minecraft statue of my fine self from you?
That's gonna take a long time.
I'll give you $5.
Just how much do you have?
I got another, my boy.
Can you leave the Xbox here?
Cause I'm lazy, and all I want is a large statue of my fine self. But you have to put a wiener on.
You think I'm not?
Yeah, you have to.
Honestly, I would have started with a wiener first.
All right, you can't gauge a man until you build him from wiener first.
No, this needs to be drawn to scale.
It's got to be Prisoner Alex, but give her a wiener. Prisoner trap Alex.
The entire skin is like two clothes, but then the wiener is just completely bare naked.
Ultimate life form. You really fucking named it that.
Yeah. I was just like, what's it? Ultimate life form. Okay. Let's do that.
Justin named a horse Ultimate Life Form.
I also named the other one Butters.
Too bad. Oh, you did. The one in Iron Butters, Armor.
That's me.
Too bad. That horse is really
too
slow.
Too bad you don't have Fudge.
Yeah. I would have never known how fast Fudge could run.
You can have the donkey.
The donkey... is faster than Butters.
Yes, yes it is.
But Quincy is faster than the donkey.
Which one's faster, Ultimate Life Form or Quincy? I want to know.
I'll test that right now. Which reminds me, I need to think of a name for my mule.
Charles Bronson.
No, not Charles fucking Bronson.
Lured.
Not lured. I'll think of something.
Are you going to give me a girl name or a guy name?
I don't know.
Maybe name it Sanchito.
No! God. Sancho and all of its fucking derivatives make me angry.
What about, name it Pepe.
No, name it Susween.
Don't name it fucking Susween.
Got that legendary dog Pokemon, Susween?
What about Ryaku? Ryaku?
No.
Too bad Entei's kind of easy.
Somebody would fuck it up.
Someone would.
Somebody would fuck it up.
But how would they pronounce it?
Auntie?
Then?
You got Auntie?
Got Auntie? got a rash of nature on the ante.
Yeah.
I think there's like some really weird names out of Pokemon that are kind of weird.
Lugia.
Ho-Oh's kind of weird by itself. Like, what? Ho-Oh?
She's a Ho. Oh.
Hey, I do kind of wonder how they how they came up with that name.
Yeah.
It's an odd, it's a very odd name.
Mutant.
What?
It's a crossbreed between a donkey and a horse.
A mule?
Yep.
Yeah. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Oh.
I was thinking abomination, but I was like, I'm not gonna be an asshole to my fucking pet.
Burrito.
Or you can call it like HM slave.
HM slave.
teacher burro strength, surf waterfall, and rock climb.
Oh, surf would be very helpful because you always dismount from in the water.
Yes, you do, and it pisses me off.
Mm-hmm. Now, if only you could attach like a propeller motor to the asshole of your burro. All-terrain vehicle.
Change the part water type now. Watch out! Don't let eat grass.
So, the ultimate life form is faster than Quincy.
What?
God damn! It is the ultimate life form. Bless you.
However, if I were to stand the ultimate life form, no freaking fucked up face to snout with a creeper, the creeper would win.
Yeah, it's just Quincy has...
Quincy would win, though.
Quincy has the armor.
Quincy has... Huh?
Quincy has the best of both worlds, I was going to say. Yeah. Speed and the durability. Meanwhile, I get, like, the most unlucky, slow animals.
Every time I find a new fucking horse, it's, like, slow as shit for you, man. I don't know why.
It's okay.
Glorified trucking.
Slowly but steady. Slow but steady.
It's like you can't fight the fast horse, man.
I mean, like, I have a good time fighting, like, gold and iron and stuff, so something had to bounce out. For me, it's slow horses.
Mare.
I have a good...
Mare.
I'm going to name my mule. I'm going to name it Mare.
Finding death. I find death quite often in Minecraft.
That's a very easily found thing.
Usually, falling from a great height seems to be my...
You jumped off the mushroom.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Yeah, I did jump off the mushroom, didn't I?
Oh, yeah, we still need to establish the whole, like, what was it, something chamber?
Oh, the freaking battle chamber.
Battle chamber. That's just cool. I want to just go in there and fight, even though I'll die.
Dude, fucking cave I found, it's almost endless, like, shit.
Oh, yeah. Just looking at the cave, like, it's pretty massive.
Cave got nothing on mine. Been searching for days.
Gabe. I barely started and it's like black. You can't see shit. That's how dark it is.
Yeah, that's how all caves start. There's no such thing as a sun inside of a cave. Like, however, there are some caves in the world that are so big that they have their own atmosphere.
What the hell?
Yeah. So they have their own weather, their own clouds, their own wind currents, all of that.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's pretty cray-cray.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
That sounds like...
All I know is if I fall, I die. And there's no getting my stuff back.
That sounds like the Aether, like, brought down to caves. I remember when that was the thing.
Hmm?
The Aether? Which,
Aether?
Yeah, Aether.
Aether! Ethernet.
Ah, that's where it comes from. What else is there to talk about?
I don't know. I'm like...
Oh! Bit of personal news. My sister is having her wedding on Tuesday.
Oh!
Yeah.
That's tough.
She's been engaged for God knows how long.
I mean, it could be worse. It could be like Jesse and Gianna from Prank vs. Prank. They're married for like... Oh, not married. They're like boyfriend, girlfriend since... I guess for 9 years, maybe?
Hey, you know what that shit reminds me of?
I don't really know specifically, but yeah.
Dude, one of my supervisors, the TL's at my work... Funny story... He said that he and his girlfriend got engaged simply because they've been together for so long he thought he was obligated to give her a ring by now.
As he kneels down, like, this had to happen at some point, so I'm just doing it now. It's like they're just waiting for a dentist appointment.
Yeah, I'm still getting mob spawning in my cave. I gotta find out how to reassess my lighting situation.
Just slap torches on everything.
But
I make it the second pit.
I'm not going to make it the second pit. I want it to look aesthetically pleasing. I want to just go willy-nilly, like, torch here, torch there.
Well, I barely have any torches on my game. Mobstone spawn.
In fact, I want to get to the point... I want to have enough, like, redstone and glowstone and all that to where I can make a freaking light switch and just turn my lights on and off.
Where do you find redstone? Because I can't find that shit.
Down.
Underground.
Like, down.
Also, I can lend you, like, maybe 7 stacks of those.
Yeah, I could offer a stack or two of it.
Well, okay, here's the thing. You know that... You know the friendship hole?
Yes.
That I dug?
Uh-huh. Oh.
I'm gonna build... I'm gonna take down there, 25 pork chops.
Mm-hmm.
115 ladders.
It's funny how you think that's gonna be enough.
And an unfathomably large amount of ladders. And I'm just gonna dig straight down until I run out of ladders. Then I'm gonna build the ladders all the way back up, climb up, make 200 more ladders, and then go back down the hole. And I'm just gonna get down to the very bottom, and I'm gonna build a base down there with a bed.
Nolan.
Huh?
Get down.
No. No, I'm talking about being angry in a hole right now, and you trying to enrich my life with a James Bond glitch?
Yeah. Hey, don't even talk to me about making holes and shit. I was the first person to make a hole out of despair.
True that.
This is very true.
R.I.P. Felicity.
I was not there. Prisoner Alex. This was before Prisoner Alex stepped onto the scene. Although currently I'm
before dressed, she broke out.
This is before. Currently I'm dressed as a naked mole rat, which makes me look absolutely just visceral and horrifying.
But so just fitting.
So god awful.
It's the worst. I look just like a wiener just walking around.
That does sound like naked mole rat.
You guys remember the naked mole rat song from freaking Kim Possible?
Yes, I'm thinking about it right now. As we speak.
That was awful. What is that? That freaking thing.
Yeah, that's right. It's a naked mole rat.
God. That is the worst possible thing.
When was the last time you guys have seen a naked mole rat, in person?
No,
I saw one at the zoo.
I saw one. Yeah, something like a zoo.
I ain't never seen no naked mole rat in my life.
Kind of just looks like a pink sock.
That's a pretty small sock.
Like a gross, pink sock that, got shrunk in the dryer and forgot about.
I don't think anyone's ever described that animal in such a way.
Well, I mean, the pink sock usually describes a prolapsed rectum, so...
Yeah.
And I just got that image.
Why?
Congratulations. Now you know what a pink sock is.
You know what's funny? I'm more than certain at least anyone who's watched porn is familiar with what it looks like too.
Ugh.
Yeah. Steven. It looks like it looks like a like from Legend of Zelda.
Oh god.
It does.
Wait, you mean 64 likes?
Yes.
Oh god.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it looks like. Thank you, Nolan, for describing it in a manner that I couldn't imagine.
No, stop.
Makes you look at likes in a different way.
You don't want to just, give it a little tug.
No.
Give some.
It's like them things that you used to get as shitty Christmas presents back in the day. A little plastic tube full of water that you do that with.
Hmm. Have you seen the meme about those?
No.
Teaching kids hand job and fingering techniques since the 80s.
Jesus.
They felt like it was an obligation at that point.
Can you put your wiener in one of those?
I'm 110% sure you could put a wiener in it.
It's remarkable that I never attempted to as a child. Sounds like something I might do.
Sounds like anything any kid between the ages of 7 and 11 would do.
I got my wiener stuck in a shampoo bottle when I was 12.
That's what I was thinking about. I was like, wasn't there something about kids sticking their wieners in? No, it was just Nolan.
I
never done that.
Local kid gets wiener stuck in a L'Oreal bottle.
I did put my literal finger in a shampoo bottle.
Yeah, but as a result,
caused tears. It did.
As a result, my pubes are silky smooth. For an eternity.
I was about to say for all eternity.
Yeah, baby soft.
Gross. That reminds me of another thing from Kim Possible. It was like a baby's bottom. Yeah. Your skin is so soft. And like a baby's bottom. I'm a
baby's bottom enthusiast. I like to take the opportunity to
Nolan, please don't dig yourself in too deep of a hole right now.
So was a baby's butt scientist. It's like, this particular baby's bottom is quite rough. The analogy is broken. Everyone go home.
The analogy is broken. Go home.
Science means nothing. Oh, jeez. Yeah.
This just in. Pediatric dermatologists commit suicide over rough baby bottom.
Yeah.
Ruining all analogies of how smooth it is.
Yeah.
Damn.
There is no God! It is as smooth as a river rock, is the new term.
River rock.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Is that a rock from the rivers?
Is a river rock not but the baby's bottom of nature?
You know what? You know what, good sir? I believe one can agree to that.
Yeah. Like, I was in the river and all I could think to myself is, man, my feet sure like it's feels like it's standing on the bodies of millions of baby asses.
Whoa, jeez.
This must be a feminist neighborhood.
So this conversation has reminded me of how there's different like scents for candles. What if there's one for baby's bottom?
What?
I would feel it smell like Johnson & Johnson.
That's exactly what it smelled like. Yeah. Johnson & Johnson's mixed with the very delicate odor of oats.
Salty coins and milk.
Have you ever noticed that? All babies smell like oats.
They do smell like oats.
Every baby in the known universe smells exactly like oats.
Yeah, they smell like fucked up Cheerios.
I was thinking more lines like...
Is eating a baby good for your cholesterol?
I was thinking more lines like, if you open a thing of Quaker Oats instant oatmeal and just sniffed it, you've smelled every baby in the known universe.
Yeah, what if you opened up a thing of oats and there was just a baby in there? It was just like, hey, it's gone.
Why does this baby have a smoker's cough?
My mom smoked a lot in the womb, okay? Some babies got problems other babies don't have, okay?
That's some accent.
What are their candles that have weird smells?
The scent like of
firework.
There's
firework. There's shooting star.
Right.
How do you smell a shooting star?
Science.
Yeah, what about mandals?
Mandals?
Yeah.
Man sandals?
No, man. The freaking candles that have...
Oh, like, manly scents?
Manly scents for, like, people that are homophobic.
Like fucking no,
I ain't gay, but that my kind of smell like bacon and beechwood and shit.
Fucking mowed lawn.
Yeah.
Motor oil.
It's the fucking stupidest thing. It's like, if you're that afraid of being gay.
Professional NFL locker room.
Ugh.
Yeah, if you're that afraid of being gay, you might as well just, you know, put a cock in your mouth and get it over with. Because you got problems.
So I'd rather smell scabs. Luckily, there's a scent for that.
Oh, gross. What? Yo, be honest with me, you guys.
Yeah.
Have you guys ever eaten a scab?
No.
Nobody's eaten a scab?
No.
No. No.
You have.
I have.
I knew that's exactly why you asked.
No, I was a child. Not only was I a proficient shampoo bottle fucker, but I was also a professional booger and scab eater.
I get boogers. Scabs?
Yeah.
I've never eaten a scab.
Munchy
and
crunchy.
I've never eaten a booger.
Crunchy, you're recycling your own nutrients.
So let's just end on that point because we're out of time.
Yeah. Dude, scabs have the same texture as like minimal amounts of beef jerky.
Dude, I don't want to know that.
Damn. Makes you think.
Yeah.
Alright. We reached the end of this time. So thank you guys so much for watching episode 101 of DangIT Prodcast. My name is Justin.
I'm Gabe.
Steven.
I'm David.
Thanks for watching. Hashtag bye. Oh, there's so many remotes.
I should have taken the moment just to be David for the day so I can just be like, I just think.